Hi students, myself Anirvan Basurai Choudhury, Lab Assistant, Department of Chemistry, JS College of Engineering. You are watching the lab video. The paper name is Chemistry 1 Lab. This is for BTech first year students. And the paper code is CH191 and CH291.
So, okay students, today I'm going to discuss about pH metric titration, the interesting one, the instrument based titration, pH metric titration. So, what is the aim of the experiment? The aim of the experiment is the determination of the unknown strength of HCl, or hydrochloric acid, by known strength of NaOH solution using pH metric method. Or using a digital pH meter. This is the aim of the experiment. So first of all, we have to discuss what is pH. Now I think everybody know the term. pH is the negative logarithm of hydrogen and concentration. Minus log base 10 is the sun. Concentration, that is the understand by pH. Okay. It is represented by this. Now, by that pH, scientist Sorensen invented a scale. So pH is a logarithmic scale. Okay. So by that scale, we can find out the acidic nature of the solution, which one is acid, which is the basic solution or alkaline solution, and also which one is the neutral solution. Okay. Now, what is the pH range? pH range is 0 to 14. Okay, so 0.1 to 6.9, this is the range of acidic pH. Okay, 7 is the neutral pH. 7 is the neutral pH, and again 7.1 to 14, that is the basic pH. This is the pH range. Now, by that range, we can very easily know which acid is weak acid, and which acid is strong acid or strong base, weak base. Like for weak acid, there is less number of H plus. Okay, because it is dependent upon the negative logarithm of hydrogen and concentration. So weak acid has less number of H plus, whereas strong acid has more number of H plus when it is dissociated. Now, this is the general part of pH metric titration. Now, in our experiment, whatever I told the aim, determination of unknown strength of HCl by sodium hydroxide solution, known strength of sodium hydroxide solution by pH metric method. Now, actually, if you think, this is a normal acid base method, isn't it? Strong acid versus strong base titration. So, by normal titration method, we can very easily do the experiment by using one in the burette, say acid in the burette, and one in the conical flask, and adding phenolphthalein indicator. Then doing the titration, we can very easily find out the unknown strength of AC. But rather than doing that, that means a normal acid base method, we are choosing the pH metric. Why? That means some reason behind it. Yes, there is a reason. We are using a digital instrument called digital pH meter. I will show you later whenever I show the experiment. So, a digital pH meter is used. Along with that, this experiment has three steps. Like, first of all, we have to determine the unknown strength of NaOH by known strength of the primary standard solution. That means the strength of the NaOH should be determined, okay, which is already determined. Now the second step the last step, that is when we determine the unknown strength of HCl by that known strength of standardized NaOH solution by a digital pH meter, that time no indicator is used. Now if the indicator is used in normal acid base method, you already saw it, maybe there is a chance of maybe some human error. It is not obvious that errors are coming. If you practice so much, it is minimized, but maybe some errors are coming. But in that particular method, the last step, there is no indicator is used. So without the indicator, we are finding the end point. That means there is a less chance of human error. This is number one point. And again, we are using a digital instrument which is calibrated properly. So result will be more accurate. Okay. Another point, after taking the reading from the pH meter, we have to plot a graph. And from the graph, actually you are getting the endpoint. That means for accuracy purpose, it is more accurate. As we do the experiment digitally, the instrument is used, and then graphically we have to find out the unknown strength of AC. Okay, and there is a less chance of human error. So for accuracy, we are choosing the method of pH metric titration. So in your syllabus, there is also another experiment, conductometric titration. They are also same method, that means same thing that we are using conductometrically. Now, in this experiment, pH metric titration, we have to prepare it out. 10 ml of unknown acid in a plastic beaker, and burette should be filled with known strength of NaOH solution, sodium hydroxide solution. So we are taking the standardized NaOH solution, that is 0.1 normal of sodium hydroxide solution is taken in the burette. So the process I show you one by one, step by step. So first of all, from the burette, we have to count the drops of NaOH. That means in 1 ml of the particular burette, you have to count how many drops of NaOH is there. That means suppose the reading is at 0, and 0 to 1, whenever you drop from the burette, you open the stopcock, then you have to count how many drops of NaOH is there. Suppose it is coming 18 drops. That means 18 drop is coming in 1 ml. 0 to 1, that is 1 ml. So in 1 ml, 18 drop is coming. So what is the volume of one drop there? The volume of one drop is 1 by 18. That should be determined. Because after doing the that observation, we have to plot the graph. And in the graph, we are plotting number of drops of NaOH versus pH. Okay. So that number of drops of NaOH should be converted into volume. That's why drop count is necessary. Again, I will repeat whenever I show it. Now, in the plastic beaker, in this titration, we are not using conical beakers. Here, beaker is used. One plastic beaker is used. This is the plastic beaker, 100 ml. Now, we have put prepared out 10 ml of unknown ACL by pipette. And this is the pipette. So, 10 ml pipette is required. So, we have prepared out 10 ml of unknown ACL in the plastic beaker. Then, we have to add some distilled water so that we can immerse the electrode. So, after taking the acid in the beaker and processes from the burette, in the burette NaOH is available. So, from the burette, you have to add the drop by drop the NaOH into that solution. So, automatically, it will show in the pH meter. Initially, it will show the pH of the acid. Then, whenever we add the drops of NaOH, that means whenever it is going to neutralization process or titration method, so it will gradually increase. That means pH of the solution is gradually start increasing. So first of all, it will increase slowly, but in the middle, you see some rapid changes are there, rapid jump of the reading is there. And afterward, again, it is start increasing, but slowly. So then you will get sigmoid-like curve. That graph also I will show you after finishing that part. You will get that graph. Then from the graph, you are finding the endpoint. Okay, and some little bit calculations are also. Okay, so this is the procedure part. That means from the burette, you have to add drop by drop. And we are adding 3 drops of NaOH every time. So uniformly you have to add 3 drops of NaOH from the burette into the HCl, that is unknown HCl solution, which is taken in the beaker. This is the process. Now I am showing you one by one. So first of all, I introduce you the pH meter, and you have to familiar with the pH meter, because pH meters are very, very sensitive instrument. So just watch the pH meter. Now look at this. This is the pH meter, okay? Digital pH meter, okay? There are 3 knobs, okay? So this is the temperature knob. That means before starting the experiment, we have to set the temperature. Then in the middle, calibration knob is there. That means the instrument should be calibrated before starting the experiment. That should be calibrated. And then in the right side, there is a check mode, pH mode, millivolt and temperature mode is there. Okay, so that knob is in the check mode. Check mode is the standby mode of the instrument. That means whenever it is not in use, that should be situated at the check mode. Now when we go to take the reading of pH, we have to move to pH mode by rotating it like this. Okay, it will show the pH mode. Okay, so it will indicate in that particular part. Okay, so digital. So only you have to handle the right side knob where check mode and pH mode is written. But other 2 knobs you should not touch. Why I am telling this? Because as I told, it is already calibrated with some buffered solution, 4 pH, 7 pH and 9 pH solution. It is so sensitive instrument that if we touch the knob other than the right side knob, maybe calibration will be damaged. Okay. Now again I am showing another part of the that pH meter. This is the glass electrode. Okay, it is connected, connected the bridge. Okay, this is the glass electrode. Okay. Now look at the electrode. Inside the electrode, there is a wire, silver wire coated with silver chloride, and some solutions are also there inside the electrode. Okay. Now when we immerse that electrode into the solution, whose pH to be determined. So that means inside the electrode there is some pH value is available, and outside the electrode there is also some pH values there, difference pH values. Now when we immerse the electrode into the solution, whose pH to be determined, so they are created a potential difference. Okay, so that potential difference is proportional to the difference of pH value. So this is the electrode that we have to insert into the solution. Now I am pipetting the unknown strength of HCl, okay, 10 ml, was plastic beaker. Why plastic beaker is taken? Because the electrode, what I show you, so we have to start the solution by the electrode. So if we take a glass beaker, so and while we are starting, maybe if it is a glass beaker, there is a chance of broken electrode. So that's why only we are taking a plastic beaker instead of a glass beaker, nothing else. Now we have to pipette it out, 10 ml of unknown HCl. So you pick up the volume. Never blow the pipette, as I told previously also. Now look, this is 10 ml, 10 ml of unknown HCl. Now if we immerse the electrode into that 10 ml, it is not sufficient. So that's why we have to add some distilled water in it. Approximately 50 to 60 ml, so that we can very easily immerse the electrode. Thank you. Okay. Now it is sufficient for immersing the electrode. Now we have to immerse the electrode into that solution. So to rinse it, like distilled water. Be careful because it is very sensitive. Very thin layer of glass membrane is there. You have to put it into or immerse it into the solution. Okay. So electrode is immersed. Okay. Now you have to stir the solution by that electrode like this. Very gently. While stirring, be careful. The lower portion should not be touched the beaker. Okay. So this is the process of stirring. Now for the burette is already filled with NaOH solution 0.1 normal NaOH, that is the strength which is given, NaOH, standardized NaOH. So before starting that particular pH metric method, as I told, you have to count the drop, that means in 1 ml from the burette, you have to count how many drops of NaOH is available. Okay, so how will you do that? So suppose it is at 2. Okay, so 2 to 3, you have to open the stop clock and count how many drops of NaOH is available. Okay, like this. Okay, so we start dropping. You see? Okay. You have to count it. So say it is coming 18 or 20 drop. Suppose in the particular burette it is coming 20 drop. So you remember that 20 drop in 1 ml. Okay, you just remember that. Now don't stop the stop clock. After taking the drop count or getting the drop count, don't stop it. Because the flow rate is very important. So the same flow rate you have to add whenever you add into that HCl solution, that NaOH part. Okay, so 3 drops every time, that is uniformly you have to add 3 drops as I told. So that 3 drop, the rate of the flow is should be same whenever you count the drop. So don't stop the stop, clamp it. Okay, now students, carefully see what happened. This is the HCl, unknown HCl is taken in the plastic beaker. I'm stirring it gently and I want to take the reading of pH. Now you go, I should go to pH mode by rotating it in the pH. So you see reading is changing. It will show 2.07. Okay, now immediately after taking the reading, that is 2.07 is coming initially for HCl or non-HCl, you have to note down in a copy. Okay, you have to note down the reading, first reading, initial reading, that is without adding any NaOH solution. Okay, and immediately you take the reading, you return to check. So the process is like this. It should be in the check mode. Whenever you take the reading of pH, you go to pH mode after stirring, then taking the reading, write down in your graph copy. Again you return to check mode and then you can add drop wise NaOH. Careful, in the whenever that knob is in the pH mode, don't give the drop from the burette. Always remember and check it whether it is in the check mode or not. If it is in the check mode, then can add the drop from the burette to the AC. Okay, now I'm showing you how we get the drop. So uniformly 3 drop, I told you, uniformly 3 drop you have to give. So give 3 drop. It is in the check mode, check position. 1, 2, 3. Now you have to start it again. okay? Gently clockwise, anti-clockwise, you have to start it. Now you go to pH mode again. You see 2 point, it is start increasing. Okay. Now again you return to check. Then give the second time, that is again 3 dog uniform. 1, 2, 3. Okay, it is in the check mode. We are adding the drop from the burette. Now again I stir it. Carefully stir it and then go to pH mode. Okay, it is start increasing. It is very slowly increasing. So this is the method. Okay, you understand? That means uniformly you have to add 3 drops of NaOH from the burette into the acid solution and start. So when the process is going on, in the middle part, you see some abrupt jump. It's a steep jump in the reading. Clear? Now you see, in the middle part, in the middle part, you see the rapid jump. Right? Like 5 to 8, 5 to 9 or 5 to 10. In that way. Okay, but again whenever you again start giving the drop, again it will increasing, but it is increasing slowly, again very slowly increasing. So this is the method. That means first of all it is increasing very slowly, but in the middle part whenever the utilization point is coming, that time suppose it is at 4.9 or 5 point something, then it will jump to 8.9 or 9 or 10. Then again it will start increasing but very slowly. This is the process. So that means you remember uniformly you have to give 3 drops. Every time you have to give 3 drops of NaOH and stir it, and you go to pH mode for taking the reading. Now immediately after taking the reading, again you have to go to return to check in. Then you can add the drop. This is the process. Okay. Now, what you have to do? You have to note down in a copy the reading from the pH. That means from the pH meter, we got the pH value of the solution. Initially, it is acidic in pH, acidic in nature. Then, whenever we add NaOH, it will start increasing, the pH will increase because it will go to neutralization point, and after neutralization point it will go to basic medium. That means increasing reading will be there. In the middle part, the important thing, in the middle part there is a sharp jump. Now I will explain it in the graph. Students, you see the drop count, suppose it is coming in your burette, maybe it will be differ for different burette. It is 20 drops in 1 ml. It is coming, suppose. So volume of 1 drop is 1 drop equals to 1 by 20 ml. Okay. Now, suppose we are getting this type of value from the pH meter, digital pH meter, what we just did now. So drops of NaOH, that is pH. So 0 drops. 0 drops means initially whenever we are taking in the beaker only the HCl part. So there is no NaOH, that's why it is 0 drops. So 0 drops, in 0 drops 2.10. Look, it is gradually increasing. In 3, we are uniformly we are adding 3 drops, that's why I am reading 0, 0, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, in that manner. Okay. So 3 drops increasing, and you see in that part, in that region, the rapid reaching. Okay, step jump. Now again afterward, that means it is indicated in that part neutralization point is there. Okay, so in afterward again we are adding gradually 3 drops of NaOH. So now it is in the basic medium, it will start again increasing but very slowly. So in that manner you have to take 14 to 15 or 16 drops of NaOH, 16 times you have to take the reading up to 42 or 45. In that manner, then you will get the actual table. So you understand that they are escape jump circle. Okay. So is in the that region. Now whenever we afterward you have to plot the graph. Okay, after doing that you have to plot the graph. This is the graph. Along x axis you are taking number of drops of periodic solution and along y axis pH. Okay, so you have to write down the scale. I think you know to do the graph properly. Now it is first of all it is increasing. Now in that part, in that region, it is rapidly increasing. That means in this region it is showing here. Okay, and again it is increasing but very slowly. Understood? So you will get sigmoid like that. Okay, so there is only one curve. So how we get the endpoint? Now already we know in the pH scale 7 is the neutral pH. So from 7 you have to draw a parallel line to x-axis, and where it is coincided that point, from there you have to draw a perpendicular line to x-axis. That is your endpoint. Suppose it is coming, say 21.3. Whatever reading is coming, you have to take that. Because for accuracy we are doing that experiment previously I told you. So we are using a graph. So whatever reading is coming from the graph, you have to take that. Don't round up. Suppose it is 21.3. Okay. Now in that region, why that rapid change is there? I will explain it. Suppose in that point, that means suppose in that region, we are giving 3 drops. Okay. And then it is coming. That we will show you. Now again we are uniformly adding 3 drops. So in the 3 drops, so many OH minus is there because we are adding NaOH na. So many OH minus ions are present. Now in that region it is very near about the neutralization point. Very near about the neutralization point. Suppose it is there. It is that point. In that point. Okay. Now suppose it is in that region only. Say for instance, only 10 OH minus is required. That means only in the solution, only 10 H plus is remain. Okay, because in the HCl, so many H plus are answered there previously, and initially, whenever we add the NaOH, H plus will react with OH minus and form H2O. So it is decreasing, H plus is decreasing. So suppose in that part, only 10 H plus is available. Now for neutralization, 10 OH minus is required, but in 3 drops there are so many OH minus present. So only 10 OH minus is bind up with H plus. That means all the H plus is neutralized by OH minus and form H2. That means neutralization is done. Then the excess, there is excess amount of OH minus is present in that particular 3 drops. So that's why some jumps are there. The tendency will be it will go to further basic region. That's what is jump. And then again, when we continuing the process, so again it will be increased because it will increase because for OH minus, that means it is in the basic medium. Okay, so this is why the graphs look like that. Now, this is the actual 21.3 support. 21.3 drops of NaOH is coming from the graph. From the graph, you get this. Now, that means 21.3 drops of NaOH is required to neutralize your HCl. Whatever HCl solution you are taking, that 21.3 drops of NaOH which is required to neutralize your HCl. Okay, now remember the aim, determination of the unknown strength of HCl by standardized NaOH. So now the calculation part is very easy using formula V1 SO1 V2 S2 normality equation. Suppose V1 is the volume of NaOH. Okay. Then S1 is the strength of NaOH. And V2 is the volume of HCl and S2 strength of HCl. So you have to determine S2, that is V1, S1 by V2, isn't it? Now V1 is the volume of energy. This is known. S1 is known because strength of energy. I told you strength of energy is 0.1 normal. Okay, this is standardized. Then V2 is 10 mm because 10 mm is prepared for HCl. 10 mm is prepared out. And S2 you have to calculate. So V1, volume of energy is required. Now from the graph, we are not getting the volume. We are getting only the drops of energy. So that drop should be converted into volume. How will you do that? By that. Because we know we are counting already drops. In one level, how many drops of energy is there? So they got one volume of one drop is 1 by 20 mm. So if we multiply that 1 by 20 with 21.3, then we get our V1. So instead of V1, we can write down 21.3 into 1 by 20 into 0.1, that is the strength, and by 10, V2 is the 10. So you will get the result, the S2. Okay, it is coming in 0.0101. So this is the strength of unknown strength of HCl, which is coming by that method, which is very easy. So from the graph, just think carefully. From the graph, we are getting number of drops of NaOH, which is coming, say, 21.3. So that drop should be converted into volume because we are using that formula, normal equation. So V1 is equal, V1 is the volume of NaOH. So how will we get it? So previously we count the drop. So from there, one drop plus 1 by 20 is calculated. So 1 by 20 into 21.3, then you get V1. Other thing is known to you. So very easily you can find the strength of unknown HCl or unknown strength of HCl is determined by the pH metric method. Okay, so this is very interesting, I think. We have already used the instrument. It's an instrument based titration. So for accuracy, we are doing the experiment. So I think all of the students just understood the method. Okay, now see you in the next class. Thank you.